So drainage.
The patterns which we will discuss in this chapter as a trellis, dendritic, parallel, dendritic, parallel. Next one is a radial, RADIAL, radial. Next one is a centripetal. Clear? Next broader part of the chapter as drainage system. Broadly, there are two drainage systems are there: Himalayan River system, which divided into three parts: Indus River system, Ganga River system. It has includes as all those number of tributaries which are basically giving as a water to that particular larger river. Third, Brahmaputra. We will discuss in detail about them. And the second is a Peninsular River system divided into two parts: eastward flowing rivers and westward flowing rivers. Yes, Renuka. Eastward flowing rivers and westward flowing rivers. Clear? Then as a landforms. So the types of landforms which are carved by the river during their in-course, all these we will discuss in this chapter. Clear? So let's start from the first, drainage patterns. Let's start from the first, drainage patterns. Drainage patterns. First is a trellis. Trellis drainage pattern or rectangular. A rectangular. So when river and their tributaries meeting at right angles is known as the trellis pattern. This is as the main river. These broader lines are the tributaries. This is the river. Tributaries. tributaries, river and tributaries, and in between of our rivers and tributaries, these are the rock masses, stones, rock structures. These are the rock structures. These are the rock structures. I'm repeating again, trellis or rectangular pattern formed by the river and their tributaries when they meet at right angles. Meet at right angles. It is generally resulted in areas which consist harder and soft rocks. Hard and soft rocks. These are the hard rocks which are not eroded by the river. Not eroded by the river. River and the tributaries, they eroded, transported, and deposited the softer rocks. Softer rocks are unconsolidated materials. Unconsolidated materials, like as a sand, silt. They are generally eroded by the river and their tributaries. So the trellis is generally occur in plateau regions. Trellis pattern occurred in, it is generally occur in plateaus, rocky masses, rock structures, where the rugged terrain has exist. In such parts, trellis pattern is generally formed. TRELLIS, trellis pattern formed by the river. Example, Tapi River, TAPI. Example is the Tapi River, TAPI. Clear? Example is the Tapi River. Yes, Pranay? Tributaries of rivers meeting river at right angles. At right angles. Their example is the Tapi River, TAPI. Tapi River, TAPI. This is as the westward flowing river of India. Westward flowing river, Tapi River. Is that clear? Second, dendritic pattern. Dendritic pattern. Dendritic pattern. Dendritic. This is also known as the tree-shaped pattern. Tree-shaped pattern. Dendritic or tree-shaped pattern is the most common. It is the most common. And widespread. This is the most common and widespread pattern to be found on the Earth's surface. In this pattern, the tributaries come from. The tributaries come from different directions to meet the same river. This is as the river. That river joined by the different number of the tributaries. This is the dendritic pattern. Dendritic pattern lies generally in foothills of mountains. Foothills means where the mountains separated from the plain areas. foothills of mountains, dendritic pattern generally occur. Example, Ganga. During their in course of a Ganga, when Ganga flowing to the Uttarakhand to Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, and finally at Bay of Bengal, it submerged in a Bay of Bengal. During their in course, different number of tributaries like as Yamuna, Ghaggar, Gandak, Son, Ken, Kosi, Betwa, Damodar, these number of tributaries, they joined the Ganga River. Clear? That's why this is known as a tree-shaped pattern. It looks like as a branches of trees. Tree-shaped pattern. Dendritic. Example, Ganga River. Is that clear? Ganga River. Second pattern. Dendritic pattern. Clear? So, like as a branches of a tree, the small streams meet larger streams and the larger streams meet still the larger streams. In the end, they meet the main river. Smaller streams, they join the larger streams and the larger streams, after they end, they join the main river. So that's why this is known as the dendritic pattern. This is known as the dendritic pattern or tree-shaped pattern. Third is a parallel drainage pattern. Parallel drainage pattern. Distributaries means the smaller streams which join together fall in a larger river. Distributaries. So the distributaries of a, not the distributaries. These are the tributaries. Tributaries are the smaller streams of water which join together to fall in a larger river is known as tributaries. Yamuna is the tributary of Ganga. And the distributaries are when a river, larger river divided into the smaller streams is known as a distributaries. Distributaries generally occur in deltas, but the tributaries in their course from the mountainous areas towards the plain areas, smaller streams, they join together to form the larger river are known as tributaries. They are generally known as the tributaries. Understood? Now the third pattern is a drainage pattern. Parallel drainage pattern. It generally occur. When numerous rivers, which are parallel to each other. which are parallel to each other and follow the regional slope. This pattern is developed on leveled areas. Rocky structures. Example, Narmada and Tapi. Narmada and Tapi rivers, Narmada and Tapi rivers, both are flowing parallel to each other. Parallel to each other. The reason is Satpura ranges. Satpura ranges are lies in between of Narmada and Tapi rivers. Narmada and Tapi rivers, which makes as the differences between the these two rivers, which are flowing parallel to each other. Parallel to each other. Clear? Parallel to each other. It is generally occur in an areas of a rocky structures. Rocky structures, which makes as the gap or a difference between the two different rivers. This is as the parallel drainage pattern. Parallel drainage pattern. Clear? Next one is a radial drainage pattern. Radial drainage pattern. RADIAL. Radial drainage pattern. Radial drainage pattern. Radial drainage pattern. Radial drainage pattern. It is also known as the centrifugal pattern. Centrifugal pattern. This is also known as the centrifugal. Centrifugal. Centrifugal means different number of streams. Different number of streams. Different streams are originates from a common center. Common center. It may be a lake or a river. I'm repeating again. Radial drainage pattern is known as centrifugal pattern. Is formed by the river, formed by the streams of rivers, which diverge from central higher point in all directions. In all directions. That central higher point, it may be a lake. It may be a lake. For example, Mansarovar Lake in Tibet. Mansarovar Lake in Tibet. It is the common source of three rivers. Brahmaputra, it is known as a Sanpo in this region. T-S-A-N-G-P-O, Sanpo. Brahmaputra known in China as a Sanpo. Clear? It originates from the Mansarovar Lake of Tibet, which is in a Kailash mountain range. Sanpo or a Brahmaputra. Second, Satluj. Satluj also originates from the Mansarovar and Indus. And Indus. And Indus. Clear? So three rivers, they are originates from a common center, Mansarovar Lake, and flow in a different directions. Indus flow towards the northwestern parts, Satluj move towards the south, and Brahmaputra flow towards the east. So all these three rivers originate from a common center as Mansarovar Lake. Clear? This is known as the radial or centrifugal pattern. Radial or centrifugal pattern. So any doubts?